they won't see me. And I'm onto stride with this.
Okay.
Oh, I don't know if we're live or not.
We're in.
I might be live. We're live. Yay. We are live. Yay. Welcome, everyone, to the Irish American Heritage Museum in Albany, New York. We're absolutely delighted to have our friend, Irish Don Kelly, with us tonight to give a concert, just to get you in the spirit and the mood for all things St. Patrick next week. We have a couple of friends down here who are volunteers at the museum, so you'll hear clapping and laughter in the background, but it's just to give him some, you know, courage and some appreciation that he can hear. I'll be monitoring your comments on Facebook. I'm Elizabeth Stack, the Executive Director here. So if you have any requests, we'd be delighted to take them. And, you know, Don will play for about 2 hours or so. And if you want more, we can, you know, discuss that at the end. But thank you very much, everyone, for joining us. We're absolutely thrilled, as I say, to be here. It's been a weird year. This was the day, last year this day, we closed for 6 months. So I'm thrilled that we hung on and that we are here, and that we have some great programs for the rest of the month to offer you on Facebook. And there still is time to register for our 5K or 10K run, which is virtual, so you've no excuse not to do it. You can actually do it sitting on your couch, which is how I plan on doing it. But register on our website, www.irish-us.org. So thank you very much, everyone. Bannock Thilo Fela Pádraig, which is Blessings of St. Patrick's Day to you. And take it away, Don.
Come in, I'll do the best I can. Come in, bring your whole bloody clan. Take it slow and easy, and I'll shake you by the hand. Sit you down, I'll treat you decent, I'm an Irish man. Well, I travelled east, I travelled west, back home from down the town. Of renown, whenever I went, the welcome mat was always waiting me. So fill your glass along with us and toast old Ireland free. Come in, come in, I'll do the best I can. Come in, bring your whole bloody clan. Take it slow and easy, and I'll take you by the hand. I'll sit you down, I'll treat you decent, I'm an Irish man. When I am gone to some other place, my memory's growing dim. Raise glass and join the toast, invite the colleagues in, and think about the good old times that you'll remember me. When the good old songs are roaring out and poker flowing free. Come in, I'll do the best I can. Come in, bring your old bloody plan. Take it slow and easy. I'll shake you by the hand. Sit you down, I'll treat you decent, I'm an Irish man. Sit you down, I'll treat you decent, I'm an Irish man.
Hey, welcome everyone. Thank you so much. Cade mi la faulcha. You know what that means? That means 100,000 welcomes. Here I am in the Irish American Heritage Museum in Quackenbush Square in Albany, New York. And right off of Clinton Avenue exit, and my wife said, well, that's an appropriate place for you. You're old, so you need to be in a museum. So here I am. I'm gonna be singing some songs for you this evening, a whole range of songs that speak of love of Irish people, some of the tragedies, some of the emigration, some songs about the Great Hunger. So I hope you enjoy my music. As Elizabeth said, if you have any requests, and if I know them, I will be happy to play them for you. Now, Dr. Elizabeth Stack is our executive director here at the museum. And she used to be a professor of Irish American history down in Fordham University. And there'll be a song a little later on that I'll sing that mentions Fordham Road, where the university is located in New York City. So I'm 6 months on the board of directors here at the museum. So as I'll be saying a couple times, we need you as a member. So think about contacting the museum. It's irish-us.org. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to sing this next song. Is a song that Kevin McCrell, who is a local artist and a local Irish songwriter. He's a wonderful artist, and he's a sculpturist, and he wrote this song. Now, I'm singing this song because here we are 1 year into the COVID experience, and hopefully we're nearing the end. Spring is coming, the March is here, we're gonna have Easter soon, we're gonna set the clocks ahead on Sunday, so it's a time really to be happy. And I know there's a lot of folks who are not so happy these days, but hopefully all the hard days are gone.
All of the hard days are gone. It's all beer and whiskey and songs from now on. We'll laugh at the darkness, dance until dawn. All of the hard days are gone. All of the hard days are gone. It's all beer and whiskey and songs from now on. We'll laugh at the darkness and dance until dawn. All of the hard days are gone. We're all safe and warm here, my friend. The bad times are over, they won't come again. So raise up your voices and give us a song. All of the hard days are gone, everybody. All of the hard days are gone. It's all beer and whiskey and songs from now on. Laugh at the darkness, dance until dawn. Oh, all of the hard days are gone. Oh, well, life has been cloudy and gray. Take a bad memory and put them away. The sun has come out, oh, we've waited so long. All of the hard days are gone. Oh, all of the hard days are gone. It's all beer and whiskey and songs from now on. We'll laugh at the darkness, go and dance until dawn. All of the hard days are gone. So raise up your glasses and sing. The hard times are gone, sure they don't need a thing. If you want to be happy, we'll take you along. Oh, all of the hard days are gone. All of the hard days are gone. It's all beer and whiskey and songs from now on. We'll laugh at the darkness and dance until dawn. All of the hard days are gone. All of the hard days are gone. All of the hard days are gone.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Now, this next tune. We live in the capital region. I grew up in Waterville. I grew up in the Port Schuyler section of Waterville. That's just south of the Arsenal. And I like to say I grew up in Port Schuyler, Waterville, County Albany, here in New York State. And we've had several of our mills closed down. Actually, there was a mill here in downtown Albany many, many years ago that closed down. The Harmony Mills in Cohoes closed down. And we have Gloversville and Amsterdam. We have mills all over. Well, over in Ireland, there is a mill that closed down, and that's the Belfast Mill. Now, last year, we had the Dublin City Ramblers that came to town, and I was fortunate enough to be the opening act for them. And they sang this song, Dublin City Ramblers. Look it up, Google it. Go on YouTube. They're a great bunch of guys. And they sang this song, so here we go. It's called The Belfast Mill.
At the east end of town, at the foot of the hill, there's a chimney so tall, it's a Belfast mill. But there's no smoke at all coming out of the hill. back. And the only tune I hear is the sound of the wind as he blows through the town. Oh, there's no children playing in the dark, narrow street, and the little man shut down. Quiet, I can sleep. And the only tune I hear is the sound of the wind as he blows through the town. Leave it spin, leave it spin. And the mill has shut down, 'twas the only life I know. Tell me, where will I go? Tell me, where will I go? And the only tune I hear is that sound of the wind. She blows through the town, leave and spin, leave and spin. Oh, I'm too old to work, and I'm too young to die. Tell me, where will I go? Family and I. And the only tune I hear is that sound of the wind. She blows through the town, leave and spin, leave and spin. At the east end of town, at the foot of the hill, there's a chimney so tall, it's a bell that is still. But there's no smoke at all coming out of the stack, for the mill has shut down, never coming back. The only tune I hear is the sound of the wind. She blows through the town, leave and spin, leave and spin. And the only tune I hear is the sound of the wind as she blows through the town, leave and spin, leave and spin. As she blows through the town,
just a bit, and let me see here. I do want to say hello to my wife Diane at home, and I also want to say a hello to Mary Sullivan. Mary Sullivan is also a board member here at the museum, and she's also the president of CSEA, New York State's strongest union, and she's technically my boss. She's elected by the members, and it was a very good choice. And so I want to say hello to Mary and all of my CSEA brothers and sisters across the state, and all the retirees across the country and even in other countries if you're watching. I want to say a special hello to Steve and Denise Seismura. They're very supportive of me and my music. They live out in Cheektowaga, which is just east of Buffalo. So this is a song that I love to sing. Christy Moore sang this song, and it's called Black is the Color. So I'm going to sing this song, but I want to tell you, Triskelly, the ladies of Triskelly, Jennifer Kalinske, Sharon Wheeler, and Nolene Drunken Miller. Those three women are amazing. They sing this song, and they're also going to have a special on St. Patrick's Day. So watch for that on Facebook. So I'm going to tune this up a little bit.
Where on she stands. black is the color of my true love's name. Who lives our lives in roses red, and the sweetest smile and the gentlest smile. I know the ground where I'm.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Well, I'm going to sing a song now. I mentioned earlier about the Angorta Moor, which is the Great Hunger. Well, back in the 1845 to 1852, thereabouts, was the Irish Hunger. It was also known as the Potato Famine. Now, we Irish believe that the British soldiers, the British government had something to do with this, that they poisoned the ground. And they poisoned the potato crops, which were the crops of the common people. They also grew other vegetables and other food stocks that they exported from Ireland. So during this time, people had to feed their family. So this is a story about Michael. Michael tried to feed his family and he stole some corn and he was arrested. He was caught and he was sent away. This is a song called The Fields of Abenrye. I hope you enjoy it. I'm gonna move my table a little bit here.
Michael, they have taken you away.
Now, you didn't know you were going to learn some stuff here tonight, did you? In 1916, there was an Irish rebellion. It was called the Easter Rebellion. And it was led by seven leaders. And one of those leaders, I mentioned Mary Sullivan before. She wasn't one of the leaders, but she would have been if she was alive back then. She won a coveted award. It's called the James Connolly Award. Now, James Connolly, I don't know if you know it, he was a Scottish-born gentleman, and he lived in Troy for a couple of years before he went back, and he led, along with Padraig Pearse and Joseph Mary Plunkett and some others, seven leaders signed the Proclamation of Independence. And on April 24th, 1916, which by the way, that is the phone number of the Irish Heritage Museum. It's 424-1916. And so April 24th, 1916, they had the Irish Rebellion. Now, all of the seven were arrested and all the seven were executed. They were buried outside of Dublin in what was called the Arbor Hill. And this is a song about one of those leaders, Joseph Mary Plunkett. He had a childhood sweetheart named Grace Gifford. And when the night before, the morning of his execution, real early in the morning, the British soldiers allowed Grace to come in, and Joseph Mary Plunkett and she were married. And they spent all of an hour or two on their honeymoon under the watchful eye of a British soldier. So it wasn't much of a honeymoon. Grace never remarried, and she lived, and she died and is buried in Dublin. So this is a song called Grace. And I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
grace, everybody. Okay.
We do have some requests.
A request?
Black Velvet Band, The Belle of Belfast City, or Wild Rover.
Okay.
All of them, maybe.
All of them, okay. first one?
The Black Velvet Band, you know.
Black Velvet. Yep. Mm-hmm. Just bear with me a second, and I will pull that song.
No pressure now, no pressure.
No pressure.
Yeah.
No pressure at all.
But do ask if you have requests. We would love to get them.
Yes, of course. Black Velvet. Sorry about that. Here we go. All right. Black Velvet Band it is. All right. The Black Velvet Band. In a new little town, the good old Elf. Hooray, this
can you do Unicorn?
The Unicorn, of course.
I said to her, is that a song?
Oh, yes. The Unicorn is a very popular song. It is a, by the Irish Rovers. All right, I haven't sung this in a while, but we'll give it a shot. Okay. All right. The Irish Rovers.
Yay!
Yes. After 50 years, or more than 50 years, they're still singing. Quick story. When I was a kid growing up in Port Schuyler, I used to work in a piano shop, and right on 3rd Avenue there. And he had the owner had a record player, and he had a 45, and it had the Unicorn song on one side, and on the other side, the flip side, I just sang that song, the Black Velvet Band, and they were both from the Irish Rovers. So here is a tonight. You having a good time? Enjoying the music? Awesome, awesome. I'm Irish Don Kelly. I'm here at the Irish American Heritage Museum on Quackenbush Square. It's a beautiful museum. I'm sitting in front of a thatched cottage, of all things, which is inside the museum. There's all kinds of displays, and it tells a story of the Irish in America. You gotta come down and you gotta visit. It's a must see. And while you're at it, we're always looking for new members because, you know, although we have all of these things here, these very nice things, we need money to be able to support it. You know, many museums have either shut down entirely or downsized. We're very fortunate to have Elizabeth Stack here as our executive director because she kept this museum going through the COVID. So thank you, Elizabeth. Thank you. All right, here we go. Now, a lot of, you know, Ireland is an island. The size of Ireland, if you took Ireland geographically and turned it just a little bit, it would fit entirely within the state of New York. And actually Ireland, the size of Ireland, both the north of Ireland, as well as the Republic, is about the size of South Carolina. And population-wise, they're at almost 5 million in the Republic and almost 2 million in the north of Ireland. So 7 million people live in Ireland. New York City alone has more than 8 million people that live there. So you can see the size. And it's amazing how in Ireland, all of this music, all of this art, all of this history, all of this, you know, sculptures and authors, all came from this little island. So it's an island. It's surrounded by water. So there's a lot of songs that have to do with sailing. And this is a song called The Irish Rover. And this is a song that many groups sing, and it's awesome. That is not good. Sorry, just trying to get this. Okay. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to lose the pick and just use my hand.
In the year of our Lord, 6 weeks and sail from the Bay of Down in the window was a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in with an elegant craft she was before and after. Then Lord, how the train winds drove over. We had 23 masts. She stood several blasts. Then she called her the Irish. When a measles broke out and the ship lost its way. find the leaf of the Irish Rover.
The Irish Rover, everyone. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, here's a couple of quick tunes here. Now, let's see here. Intro. Here we go.
Tell me, ma, when I go home, the boys will leave the girls alone. My hair needs to be cool, but that's okay, till I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is a belle of fantasy. She's a grown one, two, three, please, tell me, who is she? Albert Noni says he loves her.
Thank you.
but we had two more requests. Tura Lura Lura and the Black Velvet. No, no, the Veil, the Chieftain song. The Long Black Veil.
A Long Black, I don't know that one.
Okay. Marjorie's going to learn that one for you for the next time.
I will.
But Tura Lura is out there.
Tura Lura Lura, okay, the Irish Lullaby.
But of course, I'm still waiting for my one.
So. Okay. Yeah, it's coming up.
Yay.
This is a song for Caroline. I understand. Now, when I started at CSEA in 1981, I had no idea that there was a young man about my age over in the north of Ireland called Bobby Sands. And he was in prison because he and the others, people in prison at the same time, they wanted to be recognized as political prisoners. And the British government wouldn't do that. Margaret Thatcher was not a nice person. And she did not allow them to be considered political prisoners. So they did what they could do to try to change the mind. The last resort was a hunger strike. And Bobby Sands went on a hunger strike in March, 40 years ago. And he passed away. But I don't know why I'm telling you this now. Because this is not the song that I wanted to. I want to sing that song a little bit later on. It's called I Wish I Was Back in Derry. So I apologize for that song, but keep that in the back of your mind when I sing that other song. All right, this is another song. This is an old song. I'll take you back. I'll take you home again, Kathleen. Sorry. I'll take you home again, Kathleen, across the ocean wild and wide, to where
right here, rays of sunshine.
In Waterville Each. She's in the AOH in Waterville Each, very good friend. This is called the Boston Rose. Her brother used to call her the Boston Rose. This is a song about a person who met a girl. Maybe you've heard of the Rose of Tralee. It's a contest over in Ireland. County Kerry. And we have Elizabeth Stack is from Kerry. She's a Kerry girl. And the Boston Rose is the title that they give to a I just have water. That's good. Thanks. This is called the Boston Rose. The Wolf Tones sang this song. It's a pretty song. Her brother, God rest his soul, used to sing it to her. So this goes out to Rose Ryan Scully.
Now the autumn leaves are falling, and the tourists have all gone, and the children, they have all come back to school, and my life. There's a girl in Massachusetts.
This next tune is a little bit fast tune. Hope you like it. When sailors are out on a boat, they don't have a lot to do. And if they get a hold of some rum or they get a hold of some whiskey, then they have a good party. So here's What Are We Gonna Do with a Drunken Sailor. Nice songs, and we've got some songs, traditional old songs that we sing in the bars. It is said that well-behaved women rarely make history. So this is one in particular. If you go to Dublin, you're going to see a statue of this woman, and she is she was a fishmonger. So I think you know this song. Sing along if you know it.
In Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Maloon. She wheeled her wheelbarrow through the streets of Rotondero, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive. So
Actually requires a little bit of a story. Tommy Makeham wrote this song. Tommy Makeham and the Clancy Brothers. Well, Tommy Makeham wrote this song, and a lot of people think it was an old Irish song, but actually Tommy Makeham wrote it. And his inspiration was he was going to his home up in the north, in the County Antrim. And as he was going past this is back in the 60s, as he passed the Irish border, there's about a 2 mile gap. And the 2 mile gap before you get to the British border, he noticed an old woman walking with a cow. And the cow was on a leash. And he looked past the cow and the old woman and he saw these fields that were separated by stone walls. And there were four of those fields. So when he got between then and the time he got up to his home, he wrote this song in his mind, and then he put it down on paper. It's the Four Green Fields. Now the Four Green Fields, you may know, Ireland had four provinces: Connacht, which is west and near Mayo; Munster, which is south and near Cork and Kerry, which is east, Dublin area. So those are the four green fields. And his inspiration was this old woman represented Ireland. And the four fields are the four provinces. And this is the song.
Four green fields.
so much. Thank you. How are we doing on time? It's a quarter after. Ah, we're doing fine. We're doing fine. Okay. This is a Ewan McCall song, and it's usually sung in pubs. And Luke Kelly, I believe, sang this song, which was pretty cool. No relation. I wish it was. About Derry, up in the north. And you know how we all grow up in cities and we leave the cities and we go back to the cities many years later and they're changed, they're different. And in Derry, it changed not for the better back in those days. Days of the Troubles. So, this is the town I love so well.
By the marrow and peas once again. For what's done is done, and what's won is won, and cloth is lost and gone forever. I can only pray for a bright, brand new day in the town I
Sands. He is 40 years ago he started a hunger strike and he perished in that hunger strike, but he planted the seeds of hope, and hopefully one day the north of Ireland will become part of the whole Republic of Ireland and will be a nation once again. But this is a song that Bobby Sands actually wrote, and I heard it by Christy Moore, one of my favorite singers. And he sang, Christy Moore sang this song in 1984. And I understand, although I don't know if this is true, that Bobby Sands wrote this song while he was in prison. So it's called Back Home in Derry. Neither wind nor rain can for bravery.
bar. Comrades ghosts walk behind me. Rebel I came, well I'm still the same. And a cold winter's night you won't find me.
Dropped, but we're back and everyone is with us.
Okay.
And we do have Tour Laura. Laura, we
oh,
were
that's right,
reminded.
That's right. I'll do that right now.
And then what about, I was told to ask for Galway Bay, beautiful. I'll just put that out there.
Galway Bay.
And yes. Of course, my song wasn't played yet.
I know.
Yeah,
I'm
but
getting,
that's okay.
Getting
okay,
to
okay
it.
Yeah, good.
I'm getting to it.
Once I'm on the list, I don't mind.
You are on the list.
Okay, we're good. You're here. Yeah, oh. Thomas is R.P. Bobby Sands. So tonight actually was the first night, I just posted it earlier on today, that Tommy Makem and the Clancy Brothers appeared on Ed Sullivan.
Yeah.
So it's interesting, you know, that you
yeah,
played.
Oh, that's so nice. That's so nice. So, let's see, Irish Lullaby. Irish Lullaby.
Oh yeah, I scream.
And what was the other one? Irish?
Galway Bay and Tour Laura.
All right, and Galway Bay. All right.
No particular order.
Whiskey
in the jar.
Whiskey in the jar.
In the jar.
Whiskey in the jar.
Whiskey in the
jar.
Whiskey in
the jar. Whiskey in the jar.
Yeah, you're lying to audience, it's a few demands as well.
All right.
Brilliant job, Don. Well done. People are loving it. Great
oh,
song.
Awesome. That's so much. I'm so happy. I'm so happy. That you like it. Okay, thank you for staying. Whoever requested
Tour Laura.
Laura.
Diane.
Diane.
From our board.
Oh, all right. Over in Killarney, many years ago, me mother.
Outside the cabin door, do
I'm sitting out here outside the cabin door. So how appropriate is that?
That got a lot of reactions, I'm just going to say.
Oh, so nice.
Marion says her dad always sang this to me. Oh.
Yeah. Oh, gee. Well, here's another nice, nice song. Galloway Bay.
I went into the chamber of the day with slumber.
whiskey in the jug. Okay, here is a song about a strong woman. Actually, when she was probably about 17 or 18 years old, her name is Annie Moore. She was the very first woman, a very first person actually to set foot on Ellis Island. And as the story goes, she and her two brothers, Andrew and Philip, I believe their names were, they were on board this freighter that came over the Nevada, and they pulled into the harbor too late to get onto Ellis Island. It was New Year's Eve, and the next morning, as she was standing ready to go, she was behind a couple of people. One gentleman stood aside and allowed Annie and her two brothers to move up forward. But there was, I believe it was a German man who was standing there. And when the gangplank was connected to the boat, one of the sailors says, "Women first." So he had to step aside, and Annie Moore was the first to come across onto Ellis Island. And Annie Moore never went home. She stayed in the New York City area. She lived down in the southern part of Manhattan near the Fulton Fish Market, and married a German baker. And she lived there until she was either 47 or 50, I'm not exactly sure, 47 or 50, and she died of heart failure. Now, what happened after that was she was buried in an unmarked grave. And a lot of folks thought that she was, Annie Moore was, actually, there was another Annie Moore. She moved over to Texas, and she was killed in Texas. So the writer of this song, Brendan Graham, actually came over to the United States and had a some business down the southern part of the country. He came to New York and he went on to Ellis Island and he saw this statue of Annie, and he wanted to know about this this young woman, and he wrote this song, and it's a beautiful song, and it speaks to the immigration. And this museum here is all about immigration of Irish people that came over and the contributions they made to this country. And so again, we're at the Irish American Heritage Museum, and we need you to become members. So this is a song that I heard probably about 6 years ago with the AOH, Ancient Order of Hibernians. I'm a proud member of the Ancient Order of Hibernians here in Albany, Father Tansey, Division 5. And this song was played by a group that came over from Ireland. This is Isle of Hope, Isle of Tears.
Threshold of that aisle, opened to
found Annie. They found where she was buried, and is in Calvary Cemetery in Queens, New York, Section 20. Her headstone, which was created through donations, her family raised donations, was dedicated, and the author of this song, plus Ronan Tynan actually sang the song at the gravesite. So that was pretty special. Okay, I'm going to go to a song that someone here loves, and I'm going to sing this song, and it's... I was 18 years old, and I went down to Dublin with a fistful of money and a heartfelt dream. Take the time to make a pot, stop rushing like hell, remember old novelties to me. All the fellas would cut you for the coupon on your back, all the watch.
It's been 42 years and
law and order in the streets of New York. La na 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 na.
The streets of New York. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm just keeping an eye on your comments.
Okay. Okay.
They're
now.
Beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Here's another Kevin McCrell song that I love. It tells the story of a man who comes from Donegal, and he goes to New Orleans, and he misses his home. And he wants to go back. So it's called Home in Donegal.
Strange and unfamiliar love to every face he sees. He came here for the money, the adventure, and the crack. All he ever thinks about is indeed going back. Wish I is all his family and friends. There are times that he gives all he has to be with them again. Before the young ones move away and the old ones are all gone, for his heart times he lies a dream in the night, and he'll get a job of it to work to save the money for the flight. Lonely dreams and darkness disappear before the dawn. Million faces made away. Wish I was home.
Donegal. Thank you so much. Now, this is a song that I promised to sing for my my coach from Waterleaf High School. I played basketball many years ago. Joe Hogan. Coach Hogan, I hope you're still hanging in here. This is your song. It's called When New York Was Irish.
They were in. It was a sad new growth in a new world through good times and bad. All the parties and weddings, the kiddies and wakes, when New York was Irish, full of joy and heartbreak. I will sing you a song of days long.
Watching from Ireland, the poor man, it's 2 o'clock in the morning there, but he said he's always in Shawnee, Kansas at this time of the year because we have Sister City programs and he's missing Shawnee, but he said listening to the show makes it a bit easier. It's almost as if he's there. So he has shared it with his friends. And
what's his name?
Damien.
Hello, Damien.
I feel like you should go to sleep, Dad, but at the same time.
I'll put you to sleep.
But it's good that we're together virtually, you know.
Okay. Here's an old one, and I know you know it.
There's a tear in your eye, and I'm wondering why, for it never shall be there at all. It's as powerful in your smile, sure a stone will be.
Oh,
normally close my shows with some of these songs, so I hope you can bear with me just a couple minutes more.
Mm-hmm.
I think you'll like that. Oh, the summer time is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain time curls around the blue-bed heather hill. Lassie, you know the chorus. And same level. Thank you. This is a song that someone, I remember I was in the pub of the Capital District Irish American Association and the AOH pub as well. And this song was sung by Nathan Carter and the High Kings. And I hope you enjoy it. Well, may the road rise to meet you. Now, you know the Irish blessing, may the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm on your fields. May the rain fall softly on your fields. I screwed that up. And may God hold you in the palm of his hand. And until we meet again. Like the waves of the ocean crashing on the cliffs more, the western winds are blowing all along the Galway shore. From the high walls of Derry to the rolling hills of Kerry, all across
share tonight with my friends who have been so instrumental in getting us up and running in our new spot. As I said at the start of the concert, this was the night last year that we closed, and if it hadn't been, you know, for Caroline and Paul and Don and Gail in particular, and a whole other slew of people who are not here, I don't know that we would have been able to, you know, stay open and get painted and lights and sound and the whole shebang. So I'm grateful for that, first of all. Thank you to Don for coming down tonight
Being
on the board. You know, it's very important. And I have to say, as an immigrant, and you know, my father was on the concert from Ireland, I just am so proud of our, as Don said, you know, a tiny little island, massive. If we have 7 million people, you know, on both sides, we're lucky. And so I'm delighted that I come from that island. I miss being in Jambie Keynes on the run up to St. Patrick's Day. I'm sure we'd be having a great sing-song at home. But I'm very, very proud and happy that I can share, which is the mission of the museum here, to pass on and share the culture and heritage. And so as we go into our second slightly different St. Patrick's Day, I want you to, you know, pass these songs on. Some of them are very old, some of them are new, but they tell an old story. And of course, every immigrant story is the same. It's people who leave home, which takes courage and strength, even when it's your choice. And, you know, you build a new life in a new place. And I have found a community here that I'm delighted to be a part of, and that includes all the membership of the museum. I can't tell you how much your support has meant to us this year when we were technically closed. And so this week and this month is so important for us, always March, Irish American Heritage Month. But I want to thank you all, and I wish your families health and happiness and prosperity and safety. It's like a new year, you know, coming up to our March month. So thank you everyone for tuning in tonight. Please share this concert, support the museum, and, you know, be proud of your heritage and your culture, and share it, is what I would say. So thank you very much, everyone. Enjoy our last song. It's probably going to be a slightly sad one, because that's the way the Irish are. And but there's always tears and sunshine after the tears and laughter. So thank you very much. Good night, everyone.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Remember, that's irish-us.org.
Oh, the money that I have, I am spending in good company. And oh, the heart there I do, alas, it was too numb with me. And
Evan.